It's humming. Place of power. It's gotta be.
Thank you.
place of power. Should draw from it.
Geralt and Yennefer were reunited, but something even more important happened in Vizima. Geralt learned that Cirilla, his one-time ward, had returned from afar, and she was in danger. He was to find her, at the Emperor's command and Yennefer's behest.
gods bless you.
Witcher.
There are a lot of them beasties you've, you know.
Oi, White Knob. You are the mercy. You are the solace. You are the joy. Roots are gonna rot my gut.
What?
Freak. What do you want?
Chaplain's praying, can't you see?
Do not cast him out, brother.
What do you want?
Rejoice, for even a creature as depraved and base in nature as you can serve the glory of the eternal fire. Someone must see to the corpses on the battlefield. Necrophages defile those not already rotting in mass graves. This is not right.
That's to be my good deed for the day.
A handsomely profitable one, I might add. I know your kind don't work for free.
All right, I'll take care of it.
This will count amongst your merits. The more good one works in life, the more hallowed things are. Yes, splendid. Here are the holy oils. Dash generously and set alight, understood? I wish it to flare up to the sky, for the glory of the eternal fire and all that.
Once I've incinerated the bodies, where'll I find you?
I shall be near the bridge to Novigrad.
What now, you piece of filth?
Unbind me, before the next one's come!
When they come, I'll tend to them. Meanwhile, let's you and me chat. Like to know who I'm untying.
John Verdon. Served in the 10th Maribor Division.
Long way from your army.
The army don't exist no more. Black One smashed it to bits. I scarpered off into the woods just before that happened. Join a group of refugees. Fucking bursting with patriotism, they were. Soon as they learned I'd abandoned Temeria in her hour of need, they beat me down. Tied me up like a turkey, left me to the drowners.
Fine, I'll help.
Oh, thanks. For a minute there, I was almost sure you'd leave me to die. I'd like to thank you somehow, but I've not a chip crown to my name.
Tough. I'll take the loss.
Thanks, Witcher. May you prosper on the path.
Jacko, Hanner, go home now!
A Witcher? Not a second too soon.
Understand you have a contract for me.
Oi. It's my brother, Mickle. Been a week now since he took the women of Bellows into the hills.
The women of Bellows?
Bellows were a rich village, till the war passed through. Huts were burned down, larders cleared out, all the menfolk conscripted. Women were left to fend for themselves, without food nor shelter. No one wanted them. Redanians wouldn't let him into Novigrad, so Mickle took him to the old mines, get him out of the rain at least. And I've not had word from him since.
Could look into it, if you paid me more.
Just a smidgen too high, that. Just a smidgen too high, that. All right, my brother's life's at stake, so I can't skimp. It's a deal.
All right, I'll look for your brother. How will I recognize him?
Shouldn't be hard. He was the only lad in a group of women.
Corpses aren't always in a condition where I can determine the sex.
Corpses? Take it back. They got lost is all. But, if worst comes to worst, well... He had calfskin ankle boots, work of Master Clogs. Told him not to wear them into the hills. It'd only ruin them. But he was so proud of him.
Think I know enough. Thanks. Looking for a man. Goes by Hendrik.
What you want with him?
Want to talk to him.
What about?
Give me a bottle of something strong.
You gotta go. I'll open the back way for you.
Got company. Who is it?
Innkeep, Vorka.
Who's this one?
Brave warrior, looks like. Got two swords, see?
Oi, great boy. What's the point of having two swords?
Wonder if he keeps an extra prick in his trousers, too.
You fucking deaf. Gonna say who you are? Or do I need to loosen your tongue with me knife?
I'm a witcher. Heard you wondering about my swords. Well, one's for monsters, the other for humans. Only got one prick, though, in case you're wondering about that, too.
Don't touch him. Don't even look at him. Worse than lepers, that lot.
Saw one in action once. Killed a half dozen. Blood everywhere. Freak didn't even show a drop of sweat.
Got the stench of corpses on him.
If you want a rest, come with me. I've a bench you can use.
I step in the hut, and there's the bumpkin with what looks like his son. That's on the pretty side, I think to myself.
I say he'd probably disguised his daughter.
Horsens always managed to hide their lasses.
Thought he'd outsmarted me, the arsewipe.
Mean he hadn't.
I plowed the snot out of that little shit. Lad, lass, whatever the fuck he was.
Must have surprised the old coot. Bet he wet himself.
Thanks for not starting a row with those swine.
I don't generally poke my nose in other people's business.
Looking to stay the night?
No. I'm looking for Hendrik.
Man lives in Heatherton.
Don't know where that is.
Other side of the hill. Looked that away this morning, saw a strange glow. Imperials on the raid, perhaps. But who knows?
Anything else you can tell me about Hendrik?
Odd fellow. Arrived from who knows where and for no apparent reason. Shacked up with a widow whose husband was stabbed for a scrap of bread.
Baron's men don't like strangers.
Aye, he stays out of their way. Always seems to know when they're coming. Always manages to disappear.
Thanks, Innkeep.
Change.
Wouldn't mind a drink. Show me what you got. Bloody Baron. How'd he get that moniker? There a story to it?
A time ago, when he was still in the army, some Blackens had holed up in a dye works. Baron and his men were ordered to take it. Others might have bided their time, starved him out. But the Baron's an hasty one, attacked straight away. The Blackens surrendered. Baron and his men took most of them alive. But one of his blokes knocked over a vat of red dye. It all ran into the river. Folk took to saying that the river flowed red with blood, that the Baron had slaughtered his prisoners to a man. Been known as the Bloody Baron ever since.
Kind of ironic.
Well, a week before, he'd massacred a whole squadron in Ingholm, but far fewer heard that story.
Baron's not from around here, right?
He's Temerian, but from other parts. Folks say he deserted along with his company. Showed up here one day with his stragglers. They'd all had enough of the wandering. So they took the old lord's castle, and the Baron became master of Crow's Perch. Reckon once the Blackens feel sure they hold the land, they'll let him keep Crow's Perch, give him a true title.
Thanks. Farewell.